So, welcome everyone back to Forza Horizon 4. We've got a few street scene races left to do, so I thought we'd take out some of my favourite cars on this game that I have yet to actually drive in this series. And the first of which is this Plymouth Cuda. And yeah, once we've done the street scenes, we'll do the gauntlet race that is at the end of them. So yeah, let's get going. Recently saw a film with this in it, in a prominently in a film, and yeah, it's made me want to drive it. So yeah, let's see what it can do. So yeah, it won't be traveling between the races. Well, you guys won't see it anyway, purely because they're quite far apart. So yeah, I'll edit them out. At the end of the day, it means we get to the gauntlet quicker, which should be a pretty fun race. Not quite decided what I'm going to be driving in that yet, though. Oh dear. Oversteer to the max. Plowing our way through everything here. What is first place driving, I wonder? Something that's better handling than me, but not as quick on the streets. Out the way, Mini. I think it's a, is that a Honda or a Subaru? I can't tell. I'll guess we'll find out in a minute. Yeah, Subaru BRZ. Which, again, is no surprise that it's, you know, beat me, considering that car's a far better handling car than this, even though we have all the power in the world. So yeah, you know, second place is decent, especially for this Cuda, which I haven't really driven all that much. Influence and money in the bank. Right, let's move on to the next race after this wheel spin. Seem to get more lucky on wheel spins when I'm not recording than when I am, so I'm not expecting something good. And that's right. So yeah, let's get on to the next race. And welcome to the next race. So yeah, going to be in the Aston Martin DB4 GT Zagato. It's inevitable that I was going to drive this because, yeah, favourite car in Forza Motorsport 7, and generally one of my favourite cars of all time. So yeah, looking forward to seeing what this can do. Now granted, it doesn't have the best launch in the world because the gearbox is pretty rubbish, but it's got plenty of speed, plenty of handling, and it's really rather lightweight. Just takes a while to gather pace because of the poor launch. But outside of the launch, it's it will pick up pace. Thank you. ancient brakes coming back to haunt me there. BMW SUV getting in the way there. There's a lot of pickup trucks in this race. And then a random Vauxhall hatchback in the middle. I knew I'd have missed that. The wall took me just outside of the realm of the checkpoint, so I need to not cut that corner. The hatchback, surely. Oh damn, I have to settle for second again. Seems that my some of my favourite cars on this game are only able to get in second. But not by much this time, so yeah, there is that. But oh well. Second place is certainly better than last, or, you know, only something like that, 8th, so I still get a serious amount of money and influence out of it, so it's fine. So yeah, next race. Right, so we're going to be in the Volkswagen Corrado VR6 for this race. One of my all-time favourite front-wheel drive cars on the Forza series. This was, I think, one of the first cars I ever driven in Forza Horizon 2, so yeah, hopefully it'll be worthwhile here. Against another front wheel drive car in the Escort beside us. We've got more power. And a better sounding engine as well. Not that that's gonna help. Come on. Avatars are failing once again. Put me completely off there. Out the way, Civic. Everyone loves that version of the Civic, but I don't. Much prefer the early 2000s one. Nice variety though this time around in this race. Charger got a 80s Pontiac. Oh dear. Gonna have to drive a lot better than this in the gauntlet if we're gonna win. What that car is. It's hard to see in the night time. Guess we'll find out once we finally get a first place position. More luck in this Volkswagen than the Cuda or the Aston. What was in second place? Our Ford Escort from 92. Two different escorts in that one, but yeah, nonetheless, got a win, finally. Surprised the Pontiac came third, then again, probably has one of the more powerful engines in this race. Right, let's move on to the next one. Right, so yeah, this gauntlet is a lot longer than other street scene races, so I've gone for something with some serious performance, and yeah, Chevrolet Camaro ZR1, 650 horsepower, 650 pound-feet of torque, and yeah, easily one of my favourite modern American muscle cars, so yeah, hopefully it'll help us here. But obviously with a car this amount of power, we're going to be up against cars that have the same kind of power as well, and yeah, we've got a Corvette there. Which obviously has the same engine as this. But is even more hardcore than this one, to be honest. It's got a Mustang up front, got a BMW behind us. Well, that's the first mistake of this gauntlet race. Oh, way too hot into that corner. Sorry, whatever you were. Five have roared away from the lot. Just love how well balanced this car is. It's a restrained rage, because yeah, 650 horsepower is not a small amount of power, and yet it's just able to handle it so effortlessly. I mean, compare it to the likes of a Hellcat, which weighs a lot more and isn't anywhere near as good a handling as this. Yes, granted, it's got more power, but this is able to use it more of the time. Whereas that Hellcat might have 57 more horsepower, but a lot of that power is just wasted. Not just because of the weight, but because the handling isn't as good as this. I'd take this any day over the Hellcat, to be honest. I think the Hellcat's a little bit overrated, a little bit overhyped. How did we get into fifth? What happened to fifth place? I think he might have gone into the river or something. Just got some serious catching up to do with those top four though. Kind of bringing up my own convoy behind me as well. Oh, that BMW's got better brakes than I do. It's obviously a Corvette by the looks of things. Well, I'm just not as much as brave on the brakes as they are. Sorry. That was my fault. Just came out of that bit a bit skittish because obviously I was trying to avoid that Volkswagen jet. Whoa dear. It's a problem with you doing these kind of races first time. You struggle getting around the corners when you don't know how to take them. Nope, understeer, all over the place there. We're halfway through the race and we're in exactly middle. Need to do better than this. Completely failed there. Apologise for all the rewinds, but I want to get this right. Don't want to have to restart it and do it again for you guys. Those goddamn stone walls that seem to always catch me. Someone else has had a crash. again, someone else has had a crash. What is it with the driver tires? Whoa, dear. somehow, someone has rolled it on this course. I don't know how you managed to do that. I really don't. Whatever, we're in the top three now. Get past this, I think it's an Ascari. KZ1, I think it is. Oh, could have taken that better. Come on, I can see first place, they're right there. Percent left. We're very, very close now to the end, and we've got some way to catch up. Crash, die, flames, no, we'll settle for second, just going to have to, just didn't get the best kind of start.
Catch your breath, get your head straight, you can run it again.
Do you guys fancy seeing it again? Yeah, go on, let's try it again. We're just going to have to learn from what we failed at last time and just try and get a bit more precise on the corners, not get as easily stuck behind everyone. I mean, quite frankly, it's not as long as a race as I thought it would be. Under 8 minutes. We've had street scene races before that are about half of that, so quite frankly, I was expecting it to be a lot longer. I guess it would be a lot longer if you're in a slower car, but still. It's unlikely that I was ever going to do that. Because, you know, weren't in the most powerful of cars in the lead up to this gauntlet. Want to win it properly, more than I've ever wanted to win anything else on this game. Ford has had a problem there. That's the exact car that beat us last time. Not the exact person driving it, I don't think, but same car that beat us last time. Not by much, but obviously winning is winning, it doesn't matter by how much. I think we're in a better position than we was last time at this point. Oh God! Goddamn normal driving traffic on the driving line there. Ooh, that's close. I'd love to know how that guy rolled it last time round. Especially since he wasn't in an SUV or anything like that, so how are you? Rolled it in a low slung car, and why the driver's tires are so rubbish at driving on this version of a race on this game, I don't know. We're definitely doing better than last time. We're in sixth for about 55% last time around. Because we failed at those corners, we're now back into sixth. At least no one went in the river this time. Corvette is really shifting. Maybe this isn't the best choice of car for this event, but I was adamant to choose one that I haven't driven on this game yet, or on this series yet. That is a favourite of mine, so I'm going to stick with it. You don't give up on those you love. Even if they fail at you sometimes. Right, pretty close to the leading pack now. More so than we were last time at this point. Corvette is far behind, so we've got plenty of room. Come on, second time's the charm, we can do it. Not when we're taking corners that badly though. Bit more on the brakes. That's all it takes. There's a bit of rhyming for you. Come to get you fourth place. I'm not going to settle for that either. Anybody fancy rolling over again? Just as long as you don't hit me like last time. About a quarter, well just under a quarter to go. We're literally in spitting distance of first place unlike last time. Oh, somebody else has crashed. It's a GTR this time and I've been put off. Concentrating too much on him crashing than to not crash myself. Oh, because he's slowed down so much from having that impact, I'm finding it difficult to get around him. When you're going at this kind of speed, you don't want someone going that slow in front of you. Out the way, Porsche. I can see first. Yes, come on. We can do it. Final 10%. He's got a bigger engine than I do with that V10. But I've got more controllability, I think. Come on. Ah. Get him on the inside. Yes. Suck on that Audi. You might be more expensive than me, but you ain't got the controllability. Yes. Did it. Finally. Only took two goes.
Yes, 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 yes. Okay, breathe, Jay. Just breathe. Yeah. No, that was that was all right, I guess.
Thank you. All right. Yeah, nearly 2 seconds ahead of that. All right. Yes. So happy. So happy. Right. We get a load of money out of that. We get 59,000 credits. And a load of influence. Wheel spin. Do apologise, you can hear my cat, but he's a bit moany at the moment. But yeah, get a wheel spin out of that. And a nice big wad of money for once. So yeah, there we go. The Camaro proved worthwhile in the end. And yeah.
Hey, monkey.
It's a fantastic car, quite frankly.
That last night's marathon was one of your most incredible drives yet, I'd have to know about it, which I don't, so I won't.
Yeah, you don't know anything about it, Kira. But yeah, there we go. So yeah, street scene heavy episode, but I wanted to get those final four out of the way so we could do the marathon. So yeah, we'll carry on with the rest of this game in the next episode. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.